If you're at a stage of your business right now where you need a lot more clients, I recommend that you do a lot more personal outreach than you're probably doing. You might be looking at somebody like me who is farther along in my business, and you say, well, George basically does a bunch of content and he has enough clients, so maybe I can do a bunch of content and get enough clients. Well, yes, but not yet. When you get to the stage like I am, where you have a large enough audience that's already referring your content forward, referring new clients to you, then yes, you can just focus on content. And you know what I do is I focus, really a lot of my time goes to serving my clients, and then the rest of the time really goes to content creation, and some time goes to product and service creation, just testing new things. I don't really do any personal outreach anymore, very little of it. But right now, you might need to do a lot more personal outreach. I did that in the beginning of my business. What I mean by personal outreach is to your warm contacts and to influencers or referral sources, okay? Your warm contacts are your friends, your colleagues, people you know, basically, who if you emailed them or if you Facebook message them, they know who you are, they like you. And when you reach out to them, do it in a personal, individualized way. Do not send the same exact email you send everybody, okay? Because that just looks like spam, and people feel disrespected when you're just trying to sell to them, right? If it were that easy where you could just send a templated email to 500 friends, acquaintances, colleagues, and get enough business, then everybody would have enough clients. But it's not that easy. It takes being thoughtful about the relationship of the person you're contacting and seeing how you can relate to them. Because everybody, when the person you're contacting isn't thinking about you and, oh, how great you are, unless you've been helping them out a lot, but most people aren't thinking about you, they're thinking about their own life. And so when you reach out, you need to, and there's my sweet dog buddy being so patient and sneezing for some reason. You need to reach out in a way that's relating to them and their life. And this takes experimentation and seeing over time, as you experiment with different ways of relating to them, seeing what works, and then doing more of that kind of relating as you reach out to other people. So your warm contacts, you know, make a list of the 30 to 150 friends and colleagues, maybe family members if it's appropriate, who you believe are supportive of you. Okay, who know you, even just acquaintances that you met but you had a good connection, and plan to reach out to each person once every 3 to 6 months. And when you, and again, like I say, when I reach out to them, don't just say the same thing, but be thoughtful about how you reach out to them. And I'm not saying every single email should be completely custom, but at least the first paragraph or two should be custom to that person. And you can think, how can I help this person through my business? Not, hey George, you wanna buy my thing? It's not about that. It's like, hey George, I know you're really interested in XYZ, and I just created this blog post, or maybe you wrote something a long time ago, but I wanna share this with you because I thought it might be helpful for you or people you know. But just be thoughtful, okay? And maybe it is reaching out to say, hey George, I know that you're interested in XYZ, and I just want to give you a session for free, because I really would love for you to experience what it is that I do, and I want to help you out, and maybe 2 sessions, maybe 3 sessions for free, because I really like you and I know you have an audience, etc. By the way, just to save you some time, I have enough people reaching out to me already, so that might not be a good idea to reach out to me personally. But what I mean is reaching out to your warm contacts, and especially influencers, people who have an audience of your ideal clients. Reach out to them and offer to do something for them for free, so that they can really get to know your service or help them out in some way. This is, again, about human relationships. How would you like to be treated? Okay, how do other people like to be treated? And do the same thing. It takes experimentation and then learning over time. You know, one of the motivational speakers that I get energy from is Gary Vaynerchuk, and he says, reach out to 1,000 people. and you can expect maybe 10 of them to respond to you and go from there. And he says, you know, in the beginning, you gotta be willing to work for free for these influencers before they're willing to say, you know what, you almost guilt them into being good to you. Of course, I don't like the word guilt, but that's what I mean, is you do so much for them that they, of course, want to reciprocate. And it doesn't mean that you need to bend over backwards and you know, serve them for a year for free, but it's more like you are doing more than what other people are doing. Okay, so I hope this is helpful. I'll have more comprehensive notes in the description or notes of this video. But I just want to encourage you to don't just be sitting back and just creating content and expect people to like sign up with you. You need to be doing personal outreach, thinking about relating to another human being, being helpful to them in a way that's meaningful for them, and not spammy, not pressuring them to do something, but be genuinely helpful, and you will be pleasantly surprised when people reciprocate as a natural human being does, to then help you, either becoming your client or referring business to you. I hope this is helpful, and until the next video, be courageous and know that you really cannot make mistakes in business that's impossible to recover from. Be willing to make mistakes, be willing to experiment. Know that you will be taken care of always, and you just have to get out there and connect genuinely with others.